In this illustration, we'll see a situation when a ball is caught by a fielder in a cricket match. Here we are given that a batsman hits a shot and ball leaves his bat at 20 meters per second at an angle 45 degree, and a fielder located 25 meters away starts running along the line of ball's motion, and it is asking what must be his speed so that he'll be able to catch the ball, and we can neglect the height of the fielder. Here in situation, if we draw the figure, you can see on ground from a point, a shot is fired at an angle 45 degree with a speed 20 meters per second. And it follows a projectile path. And at a distance 25 meters away from the batsman, a fielder is located. The height of fielder we are given to neglect. He starts running in such a way that he has to catch the ball. So we are required to find the speed of this fielder so that the ball will be caught. Here in this situation, first we can find out the range of ball after the shot. In this situation, the range we can directly write as theta is 45 degree. It is maximum range, which is u square by g. So we can substitute the values. The speed is 20 square by g. So this is 40 meter. That means if this distance is 25 meter, the remaining distance where the ball will land on ground is 15 meter. Here the figure is not in proper proportion. Here we can write also that not in proportion. Just I've drawn that remaining distance is 15 meter. So here I can also calculate the time of flight of the ball, which can be given as 2u sin theta by g. The value will be 2, speed is 20 and sin 45 is 1 by root 2 divided by g. So this can be written as 2 root 2 seconds. So in this much of time, the fielder has to travel a distance 15 meters. So we can directly write the velocity required for fielder to catch the ball can be written as v, which is equals to 15 divided by 2 root 2. So this will be numerically, if you calculate it, is 5.3 meters per second. That is the result of this problem.